Good Morning Bay Street is a production of theuptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, January 27th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are fairly flat. They're on the positive side, but still trading right around zero. We've got gold down sharply this morning, retracing some of yesterday's gains. It should be interesting in the commodity markets. Some of the commodity markets in New York are going to delay opening this morning because of the bad weather in New York. Yesterday at this time, we were looking at the TSX. It was oversold. We were looking for a close above 13,293 on an hourly basis to give us an intraday buy signal. That happened in the morning, and the TSX continued to move higher. So on Thursday, we'll remain bullish as long as the TSX is above 13,320. Looking at the hourly flypaper channel, everything's okay as long as we remain above 13,350. So right now, the breakdown point for an actual sell signal is actually below the flypaper channel, and that will change probably later today if we continue to trade higher from here. Taking a look at financial services, it's in the channel right now, flat. It had an inside day yesterday. Gold made it up to the flypaper channel and stopped. Materials just creeped a little bit higher, trying to fill that open gap there. And energy was moved higher yesterday, up testing the previous high, and we'll have to see if we can break out above that. Crude oil is very weak lately, so obviously you don't need higher crude oil prices to move Canadian energy stocks higher. Taking a look at daily charts, VIX came down, closed below the lower channel line yesterday, so the VIX is now just barely on a new sell signal, and that should be supportive for higher stock prices. What worked yesterday, of course, silver stocks were up nearly 6%, materials up nearly 4%, 3.5% for gold stocks, energy stocks were up a little over 2%. For the TSX itself, it's now back on a buy signal, and so this is very frustrating for short-term traders. We've gone back and forth over the last month. Since early December, we've been in a fairly tight range, not really making any major gains. As a trader, if you're going to take every trade, then you've got to go long right now. If you're trying to filter out your trades and look for low-risk opportunities, this is certainly not a low-risk opportunity. The short-term movements that we've seen lately have not been enough to affect longer-term investors. So the midterm chart, we're still looking for a close below 13,200. For the long-term investors using the weekly charts, we're looking for a weekly close below 13,183. This is what I'm looking for in the way of a low-risk opportunity. This is the gold sector. I talked about that earlier in another presentation, but this is certainly more of a low-risk buying opportunity. Most of the major gold stocks are either in the channel or right up to the upper channel line. So if we could get fall through to the upside today, we'd see a bunch of buy signals in some major gold stocks tomorrow. Now, moving outside the TSX 60, there were some other gold stocks that did generate buy signals yesterday. And IM Gold, which has been on a buy signal for a few days now, had a huge up day yesterday. Now, the gold stock I watch is Eldorado, still waiting for a buy signal here. We need to close above 1691 to give us a buy signal on Thursday. Copper stocks traded into the channel yesterday, still on a sell signal. Still on a sell signal for fertilizer stocks. Agrium still trading below the lower channel line. Potash is reporting earnings today. It's up in the pre-market. We need to close above 167.49 to give us a buy signal on Thursday. For uranium, we're still trading in the channel, have not generated a sell signal yet. Financial services, it was an inside day yesterday, still on a sell signal. Venture exchange, inside day, still on a sell signal. Crude oil was up yesterday. Natural gas, now I made a mistake yesterday in the natural gas. It was natural gas did not generate a sell signal yesterday, even though we saw different changes on the ETFs. We still need to close below 449.90. To give us a sell signal for the futures contract itself. Taking a look at copper, we need to close above 435.80 to give us a buy signal on Thursday, 1363.96 for gold, and 2843 for silver. Take a look at the Canadian dollar, traded back in the channel yesterday. We need to close above $1.08. We need to close above 79.40 on the U.S. dollar index to generate a buy signal on Thursday. Bonds, after the Fed announcement, bonds came down yesterday. Not enough to generate a sell signal yet, but certainly undid the previous day's up move. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning. Hey, we've got a buy signal for the TSX. Not that confident that the index is going to be able to move much higher from here. I am very interested in buying gold stocks right now, so we're waiting to see if we can get fall through to the upside. It looks like the gold is unwinding its gains from yesterday in the pre-market this morning, so we'll have to see how that works out after the gold starts trading in New York. But we're at a time and place where I'd love to buy gold stocks if we see follow through to the upside. Okay, thanks for your time, folks, and we'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.